There's something happening here, but what it is ain't exactly clear.
I don't think the bands of San Francisco and the Bay Area thought beyond 4 hours, not to mention 40 years.
I didn't really think at the time my involvement in Big Brother and the Holding Company was any kind of pivotal point in musical history.
I mean, our whole point was we could make enough money to pay our rent and be able to smoke pot. We'll be happy.
We really, for a moment there, were rock gods. Nobody could believe how fast it happened. It just, all of a sudden, the day before it happened, it wasn't there. The next day, everything's changed.
The collective image that came out to the heartland of America was that the Bay Area had lost its mind.
Fear makes people follow, like, off to war, ready or not. Us and them.
This place was totally devoid of anybody with a name by 1968. They were gone.
They were stoners for the most part, and they had been brainwashed by the media.
The sign, I will take verbal abuse for spare change. Basically, you can yell at me and offend me and anything you want. Basically, verbally anyways, and I'll take it for spare change, it's cool.
You're never gonna be able to go to a magical geography that's gonna emblemize perfection. Can't do it.
Yes, the hippies happened here, the summer of love happened here, but since then, something really changed.
Back when we were a bunch of hippies, we could have made a list of all our greatest fears. All of our fears have come to pass.
The powers that be should have been thanking their lucky stars for the Haight Ashbury, you know, but they crushed it.
The summer of love taught us that revolution can come at any time, as long as there are people who yearn for change.
It could always be around the corner, but it happens in time to time, and you know, if you're lucky enough to be on the continuum, you know, go on to the next party.
Oh yeah, it taught us one more thing. If you're gonna have a revolution, make sure you have a hell of a soundtrack to go with it.